Hello everybody, this is Bob Huang here with some new Legacy action. Today I'm going to be playing Matt Nass's Tinfins deck that he got 12th with at GP Seattle. I talked to Matt after the tournament. I just made one minor change. I just changed the therapy for a Thoughtseize. There are a couple other changes he suggested, but he wasn't quite sure. So I'm just going to roll with what he used, and I think it's going to be pretty darn good. So I played a very similar deck, Reanimator Depths. And his deck is more Tinfin's Depths. It has the Dark Depths combo. It also has Living Wish to tutor for, you know, Stage, Depths, or Hexmage, as well as some other targets such as Loyal Retainers, which is a great reanimation spell, which fills the other half of your combo. So the deck is basically trying to win on turn one or two, and then either winning by getting out a Grizzlebrand, drawing the deck, sacking Children of Corliss, drawing the deck, Living Wish, crack LED, find Lab Maniac, and then win via Lab Maniac. Or you could just win by, you know, attacking with a Grizzlebrand or making a 20-20. So it's pretty straightforward. There's some decently interesting lines, I think. It plays Shallow Grave instead of Reanimate to facilitate the Grizzlebrand package. But there's also a Unburial Rites for when the game goes longer, and then you have an LED, you can crack it to flashback the Unburial Rites fairly easily. Going on to the sideboard, you know, I mentioned the tutor targets. There's Rexage as an answer to, you know, something like Blood Moon and Chalice of the Void, although it's good to note that Vampire Hexmage essentially answers Chalice of the Void, or resets it to zero at least. You got Pithing Needle and Silent Gravestone. Silent Gravestone's excellent against Deathrite and Surgical, which is, you know, the most common hate these days. And then Pithing Needles for something like maybe Jace or Caracas. And you can see, like, because we have Living Wish, we have our own Caracas on the board, just in case we play against Reanimator. So overall, I think it's a pretty powerful deck. Matt Nass said he won a ton of games on turn one or two. So let's see if we can do the same. Alright, we won the die roll, so we will be able to play. What does this have? Let's see, we have half of the combo. I think we should mulligan this. Like, we need a stage, or a hexmage, or an entomb, but I don't know, like, what else does this hand have? It has a Thoughtseize. So this hand can win if we draw. Maybe if it had a green source, I think I would keep, because then Living Wish is also a draw, but I'm going to mulligan. And this Children of Corliss does almost nothing, so we're going to chip this one. Hands on six. So what we can do, it's a little bit slow, is we can Living Wish for Grizzlebrand and Thoughtseize ourselves. But at least it's a plan, so I'm going to keep it. Don't need the LED. Blood Moon. I guess I'll get a second swamp. Slightly annoying. Hexmage. Okay, so we need to get Grizzlebrand now. So we need like a Lotus Petal. I don't know, I guess the Hexmage doesn't do too much, so I'll just play it out. All right, we found a second Thoughtseize, so we can Thoughtseize him now. Don't care about Magus. Don't really care about Trinisphere, I think. So, like, how are we winning this game? We're winning this game with, like, a Grizzlebrand. So, I think I don't care about the Trinisphere. So, we'll take the Mod Catcher. Like, I don't know. The Trinisphere does sort of slow us down. But the Mod Catcher beats us as soon as he draws two lands. Like, in order to beat the Trinisphere, all we need to do is draw a land. But actually, I guess this deck doesn't actually run that much mana sources, so I'm going to take the Trinisphere here. And if he top decks another land, I might Thoughtseize the Mod Catcher. I'll just play out this LED. And I guess I'll play out this LED. So LED is now like a discard outlet. Although, actually, never mind. It doesn't work because I'll discard the Exhum. So, yeah, I still need to keep the Thoughtseize. Urborg. Exiling Siege Gang, Trinisphere, okay. So his hand is Mod Catcher and Magus of the Moon. Do I take the Mod Catcher here? Tough. Like, what can you tutor for? You can start doing, like, Goblin Settle or Kiki Jiki to lock me out, probably. But if I Thoughtseize him, then I need to draw, like, an Entomb. But I think it's just too risky, so I think I need to just take the Mod Catcher. You know what's funny is, like, we could just win this game by attacking with a Vampire Hexmage. So we're gonna keep doing that. Oh, you know what's annoying though? With the Mod Catcher in the graveyard, if I Exhum, he gets it back, and so you get, like, a Sting Skirter. Alright, so I kill him in 5 turns, he kills me in 4, so I'm done attacking. Goblin Settler. Okay, that's weird that he's destroying the mountain, but I'll take it. Well, it looks like we're gonna brick until we die. Definitely blocking the Rabble here. Hmm. cards we can't cast. Game two. So it's mono red. I don't think any of these cards do anything, so I don't really think we need to sideboard. I don't have an answer to Blood Moon and Rexage. Although that only works if we have Lotus Petal. Try again. These decks also might have Leyline of the Void. So hopefully we have Dark Depths combo. I guess he didn't see, reanimation stuff, so maybe he wouldn't bring it in, but if he saw the LED, he theoretically could know. So this hand has Entomb and Thoughtseize for Disruption, as well as Unmask, and it has Hexmage, so we need to draw Dark Depths. Or a reanimation spell. Either Dark Depths or a reanimation spell. Or Living Wish. There's a Thoughtseize for Disruption. I think that's enough. Man, why aren't I getting these easy hands where it's like, boom, they're dead? Alright, so we're gonna fetch to play around Blood Moon. Just start off with Thoughtseize. So we have Chalice, Rabble. Log, Sting, Two City, Mountain. So I'll take the Chalice of the Void. Problem is the Rabble Master kills me pretty quickly. So next turn I will consider taking Rabble Master. LED, not quite what we're looking for. I guess the Rabble Master is mostly kept in check by Vampire Hexmage. So we'll just play that. Eggs of the Moon. Okay. God, why am I drawing all these LEDs? This card is so useless. I guess if I draw a second Entomb, then I can Entomb an Unburial Rites. Looks like a murderous red cap. Didn't expect that one. That's fine. Children of Corliss. Oh boy. Draw Living Wish. There's so many cards we can draw. But he has a Mod Catcher, so our time is about to run out. Okay. Alright, now we we got it. Entomb for Grizzlebrand. Entomb for Unburial Rites. Flashback Unburial Rites. I guess a Sting Scourger in his hand is the only issue. Although I guess we can probably unmask it. And we hit another Lotus Petal, we're in good shape. Okay. Entomb for Grizzlebrand. And how much mana are we going to have left over? Unburial Rites costs 4 to flashback. Oh, but we can't unmask if we discard our hand, but whatever. What can we do? So this is red, white. I guess, do we want to flip the mana now? Yeah, black. Unburial Rites targeting Grizzlebrand. Pay 3, get rid of this red, and we don't need any more white. And let's see if we can get lucky. Alright. So we got a Children of Corliss. Got Lotus Petal. So we can get, let's see. View sideboard. 39 cards in our graveyard, so we're pretty far away from that. We can't kill the Magus. What can we do here? We can return the children to draw a bunch more cards. We can Living Wish. So what's my game plan? Like, ideally I can draw my deck, but it seems a little bit difficult. And maybe it's not that difficult, because the second children, first children draws 7, the second children draws 14. But I do need to hit another Lotus Petal. It's possible I was supposed to float green off of the second Lotus Petal, because black is more accessible. Oh well. Alright, well, Shallow Grave. Okay, so we didn't hit the second green, but I guess we can just Shallow Grave the children again. That seems not bad. I'll cast Dark Ritual. Yeah, that's fine. Shallow Grave. I guess I can just keep doing that. That seems pretty good. Alright. Cool. This is my first time winning with the deck. I guess it actually is pretty likely once you reach a certain point. Dark Ritual. Alright, so we want a Living Wish for Lab Maniac soonish, but I guess we can Shallow Grave first. I'll exhume. Why not? And I'm going to unmask him, actually, just in case he has something crazy. But oh, wait, no, we know his hand. It's Rabble Master and Sting Scourger, so we can skip that step. Cast our rituals. Cast Living Wish. Yes. Lab Maniac. And win the game. Okay, all right. So that was fun. Do we want to change anything? I wish we had an answer to Magus of the Moon. And honestly, like, yeah, this Dark Tufts comp is pretty bad. But, like, what can I replace it with? I could have Pipping Needle for Mogcatcher. Seems pretty medium. Yeah, honestly, yeah, the Dark Tufts combo just seems really bad against him. But I guess I just gotta hope he doesn't have it. No, there's just no sideboard cards, I think, that we can use other than Pithing Needle, which is super medium. And then LED is kind of bad, but it helps us some of the time. Like we saw with Unburial Rites, so just try it. Right, so this hand, I can Living Wish for Loyal Retainers, but I need a card, I need a creature to discard. So, doesn't seem like the best. This hand's weak to too many things. Ugh, this hand also kind of stinks. It needs an Entomb. I don't know. I think we can maybe still do better on five. Like, it has no disruption either. Alright. This hand is turn one, 2020, so we're keeping it. If he goes turn one Chalice, he goes turn one Blood Moon, we want this. If he goes turn one Chalice, we want this. So I'll just keep it. I mean, it's kind of annoying that we have to go for the 2020 plan, but he has to have it, so. Oh, if not Blood Moon or Magus. Okay, well, against Magus or Blood Moon, we just more or less can't win with this hand, but. Okay, he imprinted Blood Moon, so that definitely means Blood Moon. Trinisphere. That's also bad for us, but we can sort of win. But I'm guessing he's gonna follow it up with a Blood Moon, so. Given that he imprinted Blood Moon. I think we're pretty dead here. We get a Goblin Settler. And if he goes a Kiki Jiki next turn, I'll scoop. That's a pretty good hand from him. Turn one, Trinisphere. Turn two, Mogcatcher. Turn three, get a Goblin Settler. Don't even need Blood Moon. If he shows us a Kiki Jiki, we're gonna scoop. Yep, all right. All right, back for round two. All right, we're playing against Eric, who's one of my friends who I worked with on the Reanimator Depths deck. Right, can't mulligan this hand. He usually plays Black Red Reanimator, so we'll see if he's on that. Looks to be the case. Unfortunately, he has a turn on us, but I don't think we could have mulliganed this. Dark Ritual, Dark Ritual. Not quite. Alright, so what can we do here? I guess we just play a scrub land and pass. Animate dead. Yep, that's bad for us. Can we realistically beat him? Like, if he lets us untap, we win. So I guess we can still realistically beat him, even if he unmasks us. Like, if we just top deck a reanimation spell, Ball of Therapy. So, yeah, we're just gonna show him what we're playing. I'm sure he's gonna get these out of our hand one way or the other, so. Like, even if he sacks the Grizzlebrand, I guess actually if he sacks the Grizzlebrand to get it out of our hands, I mean he has 15 cards, so I'm sure he's gonna be able to reanimate something. So yeah, he definitely has to sack it. Hopefully we can top deck. Like, ew, why is he playing all these Cabal Therapies? Seems kind of bad. I mean, so I know his sideboard has like more Grim Lavamancers, so maybe it's okay there. Okay. All right, so he's gonna get a Chancellor back, which is not good for us. I guess I misplayed. I should have played the Urborg, because then if we top deck Dark Deaths, we could have made a turn 3 2020. Yeah, we're kind of punished here. I like hid the Urborg because I didn't want him to see what we were on. But that was just a lower consideration, I think. Than being able to make a turn 3 2020. And if we did do that, would we have been able to win? Quite possibly. Unless he reanimates like a six power thing here. We can still make a 2020 if we draw a Dark Ritual or Lotus Petal. He's sacking Grizzlebrand. Oh boy. My Grizzlebrand, interesting, because that plays around Shallow Grave. Entomb. Okay, so I think he's gonna get Tide Spout. Yeah, there we go. So even if we that's funny. We did Dry Dock Ritual. Oh, the problem with the Dark Writ is it doesn't work here because of the Chancellor. We need to tap the stage. Okay, alright, we'll skip that. Alright, against Reanimator. What can we do? Silent Gravestone. It shuts off Reanimate and Animate Dead. So I actually think we do want that. Can take out LED. One LED. Do we want this Unburial Rites? I think it's a little bit too slow, so we'll just take that out. It's also bad with Silent Gravestone. So we'll try taking out two LEDs and the Unburial Rites. Exhum is usually not good in the mirror, but I think with this build, you kind of just have to play it. And you want a couple LEDs to draw into for your Living Wish. Would you like to play first? Yes. So this hand has a Silent Gravestone and two reanimation spells. So we just need to draw Entomb. We need to draw Entomb. Living Wish doesn't quite do it. Not that close to the combo. So basically this hand is just like Silent Gravestone's good. Like, Entomb would just be better. I think it sounds okay, but I would probably keep it on 6, but I'll try for better on 7. Alright, now we found our Entomb, so we'll keep this. Second Entomb is not nearly as useful. On top. I mean, I guess we could unmask him now. Play the fetch land in case we want to shuffle it away. Play a Lotus Petal. The question is if we want to unmask him. Like, we could get rid of the Entomb and then draw another Entomb, but we still need another combo piece. Need Dark Traps. Yeah, I feel like we should just unmask him and then draw our own Entomb. I don't know. No, I'm just gonna keep our Entomb. It's kind of risky, but we need to draw a card that can help us win too, so. Asking me, exiling Exhumed. I'm actually gonna let this happen, so then I can just. Oh, he's unmasking himself. That's lame. Wish I had Coffin Purge. Or Silent Gravestone. Yeah, it's tough here. I don't know. I don't think it was super likely for him to have another turn one, but something within the realm of possibility. I don't know. I mean, we can still win here if we top deck a Shallow Grave or an Exhum. But he has a bajillion cards in hand, so it's probably not super likely. We could win with Dark Deck, top deck as well. Yeah, like, we definitely couldn't mulligan. And so the question was, like, was giving ourselves a random draw better than unmasking? I mean, I could have unmasked pitching the Hexmage, actually. That probably would have been better because we have a stage. Ended up working out in our favor. He has a Tide Spout, so I just need to make sure to do this end step, and if he doesn't have an Entomb, we could maybe steal a game. But he didn't even. Oh, he Duress, so he could only take Unmask. So basically, he needs to find an Entomb. Or some other instant way to bounce the 2020. But he needs to reanimate the Tide Spout and then have some way to bounce the 2020 end step. I guess he could chump with the Tide Spout, which probably would still be good enough. Then he could just bring it back and then bounce it. So yeah, our chances of winning this are super low. Yeah, I think we're just forced into it. Okay, Dark Ritual works too, so. Womp womp. Magus of the Moon. That was a beating. Right, back. For round three, let's see if we can win a match. This hand, like, I can Living Wish for a Grizzlebrand, but then I need to draw LED to discard it. Man, why do I keep getting these awkward hands? Why can't I just have like a nice, easy kill him on turn one hand? Like, I don't know, this hand doesn't really do enough, I think. I'm gonna mulligan. Like, you're looking for Dark Depths or Entomb in most hands. Okay. This hand's better. Actually still missing a bunch. Like, we can entomb now, but we still need the reanimation spell. Gosh, this is so frustrating. Whatever, I'll just keep it. Hopefully we can scry into something good. It's not that good. I'll just leave it on top until I fetch it away. Do I want to play any of these? Play a lotus petal in case he like probe therapies me or something. That's fine. Thoughtseize. Get a Griddle Daddy. Let's see what I can top deck. That's not useful. Man, this deck is basically built around having good opening hands, and I just haven't had great opening hands. Such is life. What's going on over here? Snapcaster Mage. Looks like he's going to snap Thoughtseize probably, which I'm happy with. If I had something I could do, I would have done it, buddy. Alright, so it looks like we're playing check pile. Shallow Grave. Not bad. Let's do a force check. Alright, you are super dead. Let's attack. Alright, do we find Unmask? Or Children? Nope. We can Living Wish for it. Yeah, so we're definitely winning this turn, so I'll just play the swamp. Thoughtseize him. Take his bolt. Chewy! Alright, Alright, so we need to go to Children of Corliss off the Living Wish. Do we have... What do we have? Alright, so... Is there anything else we can do? I don't think so. Oh. Hold on. Crap, I just realized something. We drew all three of our Living Wishes. So that's mildly annoying. Is there anything I can do then? So his hand is Edict and a bunch of lands. Huh. Yeah, that's super annoying. I guess there's no actual way for me to kill him, as far as I can tell. So maybe I misplayed by not Living Wish for the Children's earlier, just to stop us from drawing all of our living wishes. So that's an interesting thing I didn't consider at all. It's funny, just playing decks like this in Gristlebrands, like you run into situations like this that you just like completely don't think about. Like I could get the Lab Maniac here, but it's not going to be enough, and we don't have Entomb to find the one in our deck, so we're just gonna find we're just gonna find the children here, and the question is if I want to float mana. I guess I'll float black. So I'll get white and black, and then I'll let it resolve. Okay, well, he just scooped to that. So it looks like a check pile style deck, so I'll just bring in Silent Gravestone. Cut LED. And what else do I cut here? I'm not sure which matchups I want on Burial Rites. I guess it has. I don't know, I guess whenever I bring in Gravestone, I'll just take out Rites because I'll just feel so bad if I have both. So, alright, back for game two. Has Dark Depths. And Thoughtseize. So we draw a Grizzlebrand or Hexmage or Stage. Try it. Roll to five, so that's good. Right. Don't know if he has green mana. We're just gonna Thoughtseize him. Hopefully that's gonna buy us a bunch of time. And we can always go to discard if we draw Grizzlebrand. But he also has Deathrite, so that's not the best plan anyways. He's pretty far from casting Leovold. He needs a green or a blue source. Okay, never mind. I guess he's not that far then. What does Leovold do? It. Turns off Grizzlebrand. Probably winning with Dark Depths. I don't know, I think it's fine to just leave him with a force. Because Dark Depths beats force anyways. So, Foul Badlands. Does mean if we exhume, then he gets his Leovold back. So that effectively turns off Grizzlebrand. But, I mean, maybe a 7/7 lifelink will be enough, anyways. This makes it awkward, because if he, like, draws any blue spell, like, he has a force in hand, it's gonna be really awkward for him to cast. Okay, that's good. We can make a 20/20 next turn just by casting Dark Ritual. Yeah, I guess I don't care if he forces the ritual, and hypothetically, I just don't want to give him lands in my graveyard, so I'm going to do this on his end step. He can't cast Edict. Or I guess he can cast Edict once I sack my lands. Alright, he had nothing. Cool. Alright, so back on the play, game three. Ugh, all these hands don't really do anything. So we're gonna mulligan again. I think this deck is supposed to mulligan a lot. This hand has Dark Depth. Gosh, LED is so bad. It's literally just only good when you like have Living Wish, pretty much. I don't think I can go to six. So what's my play? Like, how do I even win with this hand? Like, I need a draw, an Entomb, or Hexmage, or Stage. I guess LED is okay with Stage Depths. Whatever, we'll keep and see what happens. Leave it on top and probably shuffle it away. I'm just not gonna thought seize him. Actually, it's a land. I could use it to cast Shallow Grave. So maybe I would keep it. Keeping the thought seize in case we want to thought seize ourselves. Ridane. Alright, so this is combo, most likely. Although I guess actually check piles started to play Preordained, so it could still be check pile. This is annoying, because I need the land to cast Shallow Grave, but like the best way to win is to draw Stage. I feel like we're supposed to just keep it and then Thoughtseize him. God, this hand was just so medium. Like, even if we do draw in two, we still need a mana. So I guess I have to keep this land. And we'll just thought seize him in case he's on combo. Okay. I guess we take his force. You know what else LED can do? It can tick down Dark Depths. So, that is a thing that LED can do. YOLO. Just gonna play these stupid things. I think at some point in Magic, you would have been able to, like, discard Crack Mana for LED and cast Shallow Grave. But unfortunately, we're past that time, so. And we're probably dead, actually. I guess I could have kept all these things in my hand. Just for this situation. So yeah, I guess we'll see if we could have won. It's funny to ask you for graveyard order once you start playing Shallow Grave. I don't know why he. Oh, I guess because of. So we would have had Lotus Petal in our hand. Lotus Petal LED. Would you look at that? What's funny is if he counters this, we can just keep Shallow Graving. Okay. Could have tapped mana for that. I don't know what he's thinking about. If it's a creature or a cantrip, you keep it. Otherwise, you shuffle. If it's a Force of Will, I'd probably still shuffle. Like, there's no point. It's not really doing much. I could draw a stage and kill him. So he chose not to shuffle. I'll play this in case he has Spell Pierce. Another forest. Yeah, that's fine. Well, if he was here, we'd probably win. And if he doesn't, we're dead. Shrewd analysis. Ponder, okay. Shuffle. Oh, he found something. Alright. Game two. We can bring in Bithing Needle. Crocus is really good. The question is if we want it in our deck or a Living Wish Ward. I think Living Wish Warding it Living Wish Ward is probably better. Crappy LEDs can go. Real Rights feels really slow too. I'll do LED over on Real Rights. Yeah. Yeah, Unmask is also tough because you don't actually have that many black spells. I mean, you have a lot, but there's none that you necessarily want to pitch unless you already have everything. This sounds good. Sounds great. Thank you for finally giving us an awesome hand. All All right, so I guess I'm gonna just start with an unmask. Pitching a dark ritual. Okay, no blue mana. Did he scry at the top or bottom? Bottom. All right, well, that's fine. We'll take his show and tell, I think. Well, we take his ponder, but then he gets blue mana, he puts in Grizzlebrand. That's kind of annoying. Beat show and tell anyways. I think we can just take the sneak attack. Because he has a chump. Okay, so we'll take sneak attack. I mean, the other option would take Grizzlebrand. That is actually probably the best option. Take Grizzlebrand. He needs to find a creature. All right, fine. We'll take Grizzlebrand. Ponder, show, sneak, tomb, city. And why not? Just in tune here. Easy game. Run it back. He might board in something like Blood Moon or like Echoing Truth. This sounds great. Thank you for giving me more awesome hands. I really appreciate it. Sure, let's use that. It came to jam. Ready? So we can Living Wish for loyal retainers. The only awkward thing is we need another. Okay, so that shuts that off. Okay, so now we can Living Wish for a Dark Depths. What's the better order to do it? I think it might be better to do it now when he has a lower chance of drawing another spell pierce. I guess I could Living Wish for a Rexage as well. So I'm not entirely sure what I want, so I'm just going to. Play Hexmage first. I didn't need to sack the fetch land, but we need a green source anyways. I guess I just didn't want to remind him that he could tap his Tarn. But it's like minor. Like, ideally, if I knew he knew that, then I would probably not have sacked, but whatever. Minor. Okay, Thoughtseize is a card. The only problem is if I Thoughtseize, I can't. I can Thoughtseize him, but then, yeah, but then I can't make a 20/20 this turn. Is it worth slowing myself down a turn? I think it probably is fine. Plus, he might have like a Fluster Storm or something. So. Oh, he has both. That is really annoying. This will take one. Like Fluster Storm and then play Living Wish through Spell Pierce next turn. To show Sneak. I feel like he should cast the sneak attack, but it's good for us that he didn't. I think we just get those Dark Depths and get him next turn. Like, if he played the sneak attack last turn, then he would have been able to top deck a creature to maybe kill us this turn. But because he didn't, then we should be in good shape. So, if you found Emrakul here, or Grizzlebrand. I don't think there's anything we can do. Like, we kind of just lose that. Grizzlebrand. Okay, so he still needs to find the Emrakul, which I think, as well as. Oh, he hasn't played a land. So I think he has a pretty good chance of doing. Okay, but then he didn't play a red source, so he can't draw seven, so he needs to have it in his hand now. Which I think he does. Alright. Well, didn't get there. Alright, back for our last round. What do we have here? God, I hate the card LED so much. I don't know if you guys noticed that. But this hand is actually good. We can turn one Dark Root Thoughtseize ourselves. Windswept Heath. Infect, perhaps? Okay, that's very interesting. Yeah, so in case it's like Maverick. Why not? Let's use us. Shallow grave. Do I want to crack the LEDs? I think not, because I actually want those living wish in case this gets countered. And if this resolves, I'm sure we'll be fine. Okay. Now I wanna. Okay. Well, he's not even gonna let us think about this. I accept that offer. Not gonna sideboard. Yeah, like Winsome Teeth indicates Maverick or like. In fact, it could indicate miracles if it's just straight blue-white. Which Purple Gambit actually seems somewhat reasonable that he's on miracles. If it were miracles, what would I do? I think I wouldn't sideboard. If it were Maverick, which seems unlikely because he didn't have a turn one play, but if it were Maverick, I would probably bring in Silent Gravestone. And for infect, I would probably not sideboard. So yeah, that's like, I guess one of the nice things about this deck is like you basically don't need a sideboard. You have five sideboard cards. They're all artifacts. This hand, I can go turn one, discard, turn two, dark red, exhume. I can also top deck dark depths. I'll try it. Scry to the top. Bayou. Okay, so maybe it is Maverick. Noble Hierarch. Hex Mage. Card goes around. Hopefully he doesn't have a surgical. He looks like Maverick. I'd be kind of surprised if he didn't have a surgical here. Because he doesn't seem to be doing that much. Oh, Containment Priest? Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, I guess it's not a May. I don't think I actually have a way of killing Containment Priest. I think we're in trouble this game, given that it's Maverick. 2020 is not that good against them. They have Caracas and Swords of Plowshares. And I don't think we have a way of killing Containment Priest. So my plan for the—I don't think we can win this game anymore. But my plan for the rest of the game is basically to see like what they have in their deck, so that can help us for game three maybe. Like against Maverick, I mentioned Silent Gravestone, but maybe Pithing Needle is just better because it also stops Caracas. So yeah, I definitely think Pithing Needle's better. So bringing in Pithing Needle, like, there's just no answer for Containment Priest. That seems kind of like an oversight. I don't know what answer for a priest I could play. Like, is there there's Murderous Red Cap that costs 4 mana. What is a creature or a land that can kill containment priests that would be reasonable to play? Renegade Rallier. Cute. There's much we can do. Guess I'm just gonna Thoughtseize him the turn before we lose. But yeah, there's just like not much we can do, so I'm just gonna chill. Like, we can't beat Caracas, which I assume is in his deck. We can't beat Caracas plus Containment Priest. Like, the only way we could, that I could think of, is if we, like, hard cast Grizzlebrand and then draw a bunch of cards that way, but obviously our life total's too low for that out. Alright, so we're done next turn, so I'm just gonna Thoughtseize him and Scoop. Scrubranger. Alright. You got it. So we want Pithing Needle. We can cut LED. Leave them barrel rights. Alright, try this. Pithing Needles for Deathrite and Caracas. What is this deck missing? I feel like Fourth Orberg might be good, but I don't know how the mana works out. Yeesh. So close to being good. Yeah, I gotta ship this. If I had a Grizzlebrand, I would consider it just because we have Unmasked Shallowgrave. But even then, it's probably still a mulligan. Oh man, I'm getting all these hands that are just like not quite good enough. Right, try this. Hexmage is good. So this, ugh, this is frustrating. I guess I'll keep it. And I'm probably gonna sh need to shuffle it away. Like, because going for the 20/20 in this matchup just loses to so many different things. But on five, I don't know if I can do that much better. And the Entomb for Unburial rights here. Is just too slow. So I guess we're just gonna go make a 20/20 and then lose to Sword Splashers. Still get the Grizzlebrand here. It's whatever. Because that gives us a window. Actually, it doesn't really give us a window to draw a card. I don't know. Because we need to draw a land plus a Shallowgrave. So we lose to Caracas or Source of Plowshares. Oh, you know what? He actually can gain some life here. Slightly annoying. He would have been able to do that either way, so. If he had crippling fatigue, we could kill his death right, which would cut him off white. He could ghost quarter himself. Alright, he didn't find it out. Okay, so we went 2-3, but in games we won 6 games. 3, 4, 5, 6, and we lost 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we went 6-7 in games. I think we got a little bit unlucky in that we didn't have too many super amazing turn one kills, which I think this is, you know, the reason you play a deck like this. I hate LED. I understand why it's in the deck, but as you saw, we boarded it out in almost every matchup. So I wonder if there's another way to build the deck with fewer LEDs, like maybe 2. And like, the other cards that Matt said were kind of bad were Sylvan Safekeeper. And I can see that. It just seems really hard to set up a situation where you have a 20-20 and then get a Sylvan Safekeeper. Like, you just don't have that many resources. So I can see cutting Safekeeper. I think, like, what else? What underperformed? LED, Safekeeper. All the other cards, I think, actually do have some use. Yeah, I mean, Grizzle Brand's not good either. It's just, like, if you have a Thought Seize or an Unmask. Like, because if you have LED, it doesn't really work, because, as we saw, every time you crack LED to discard Grizzle Brand, you also discard your Shallow Grave or Exhumed. So I don't really think Grizzle Brand's that necessary either. So yeah, I definitely think this deck has potential. I think we got a little bit unlucky to go 2-3. But I think it can also be built to be a little bit better. So yeah, that's it for the series. I hope you guys enjoyed. I haven't been putting out much Legacy content because I've been kind of bored with the format, but this was a deck that I like looked at and was like, wow, this deck is awesome. And so I wanted to try it out. So yeah, hopefully the format changes, because then I'll be excited to write about it again. But that's it for now. Thanks for watching.